Joining me now is a rising star in the Democratic Party, San Antonio Mayor Julián Castro. Mr. Mayor, it's a pleasure, first of all, having you on the show.
Great to be with you, Reverend.
Why isn't the GOP getting the message?
Well, that's a good question, and you had a couple of clips there that are so indicative of where the party is right now. After the November 6th election, they recognize that there's a problem, and particularly because anywhere from 71 to 75% of the Latino community voted for President Obama, a high watermark since Bill Clinton's re-election against Bob Dole in 96. They just don't know what to make of it. And the first thing that they gravitate toward is this old line about having to change the tone or change the message. What they're not getting is that it's not just about changing the tone. It's not just about not talking about electrified fences and not being uncivil. It's also about fundamentally changing the policies that they embrace. Being more willing to engage in conversations and discussions and actually get comprehensive immigration reform done, get the DREAM Act done. Think about and include the Latino community as part of the fabric, the family of the United States, which it clearly is and always has been. When they think about the Latino community, you can tell that both in tone and in policy, they think of it as something foreign. And that's not the case at all. So they need to improve both the tone, but more importantly, they need to change the policy behind the party.
Talking about policy, the president is poised to make a push for immigration reform after the new year. The Los Angeles Times reports, and I'm quoting, as soon as the confrontation over the fiscal policy winds down, the Obama administration will begin an all-out drive for comprehensive immigration reform, including seeking a path to citizenship for 11 million illegal immigrants. We will see then where the Republicans are. What do you hope to see in the immigration reform if it is real and meaningful to bring us toward a better place in the country, Mr. Mayor?
My hope is that comprehensive immigration reform will be just that. It's going to be comprehensive. It's going to include, of course, additional measures to ensure that we secure our borders. It's going to include ways to work with employers so that we ensure that fewer employers hire folks who are here undocumented. And third, it's going to include a pathway to citizenship, to full citizenship, for the 11 or 12 million folks who are here, who are undocumented, illegal, whatever term folks want to use, who I believe should be addressed. And we've heard in the last couple of weeks some heartburn among Republicans who are now just starting to consider the idea of comprehensive immigration reform as to whether they want to actually allow folks to become full-fledged citizens. And right now, that seems to be the fault line. My hope is that enough Republicans will see that they ought to allow a path to citizenship, find people, make sure they learn English, put them at the back of the line, but ensure that there is a path to citizenship.
Now, 62% of Americans poll support reform that's illegal immigrants can earn citizenship. This is a political George Washington University poll. And even since the election, we're seeing Republicans have sounded far more pro-immigration than before. Listen to this.
And we need to have what is good economic policy for America on immigration, because we do need labor. We need skilled workers, and we need unskilled workers.
We need to be firm and fair. Self-deportation's not going to work.
Obviously, we have to do immigration reform.
Well, I think a comprehensive approach is long overdue. And I'm confident that the president, myself, others, can find the common ground to take care of this issue once and for all.
Now, when you hear what they were saying before the election, when you look back, Mr. Mayor, the last couple of years with some very, very, in my opinion, almost unpardonable legislation in immigration. We marched in Arizona and other places where it was really profiling. Why do you think all of a sudden we're hearing a new tone? Is it that the Latino community used the ballot to really strike back at those that seemingly were striking at them and other immigrants?
Yeah, it was a very important moment for the Latino community because, for the first time on a major issue, the Latino community could see that the fact that it came out, that it turned out in the presidential election, made a huge difference, or could make a huge difference, in terms of the policy direction of this country, specifically on immigration reform. And it's night and day. I mean, you play their clips before the election and after the election, and as folks say, elections have consequences, and one of the consequences is, and the Republican Party recognizes, that they need to support comprehensive immigration reform. Now, what the details of that are, hopefully they can work that out.
One of the things that I think you brought home during the Democratic Convention is the personal investment that many Latino citizens have, and those that want to be, in trying to attain the American dream. This is not something anti-American. This is pro-American by people that are citizens here and want to see their families get what Americans have promised the world.
Yeah, so many times during these last couple of years where this immigration debate has been raging, I've listened to Republicans talk about immigrants, and particularly Latinos, as though they're foreign, as though they bring different values to the country. And I represent San Antonio, and San Antonio is 63% Latino. And you know, we have Latinos who have been here for generations, been serving in the military, been getting a good education. They're professionals. They bring the same faith, the same values, the same work ethic that have made America great. In fact, they have been part of making America great. So during this debate that we have in Congress, I hope that folks will recognize that this community they're talking about is a community that has been contributing greatly to the success of the United States. It's not a Johnny-come-lately community.
Mayor Julian Castro, thank you for your time
tonight. Thank you.